In the early days of rock and roll, Roy Orbison was famous for his falsetto. So when his sons found an old song of his, they knew the world would want to listen, and they wanted to sing along. Now it is part of a new CD and documentary called Mystery Girl Deluxe. Jim Axelrod is here with the personal journey of Roy's boys. Jim, good morning.
Oh, good morning, Charlie. 25 years after his death, Roy Orbison's sons thought they'd heard everything their father had ever recorded. Then they stumbled upon something they hadn't heard. And for them, it was no different than finding buried treasure, except it was even more valuable. Only the
lonely. His was one of the great voices of rock and roll. But make no mistake, when Roy Orbison sang, that chill-inducing tenor was something much closer to opera. Orbison was a founding father of rock and roll. Between 1960 and 1965, he recorded 9 top 10 singles, including his most famous. But if you ask any one of Orbison's 3 sons, this was a rock star who had his priorities straight.
When we got home from school, he was there to open the door. He drove us to school, driving kids to school in the morning. Maybe it would have been, well, not all rock stars do that.
Orbison had lost his first 2 sons in a house fire, so he kept Wesley, Roy Jr., and Alex very close. All 3 were budding musicians who wanted only to one day play in their father's band. But in 1988, right after recording the album Mystery Girl, Roy Orbison died from a heart attack.
You know, I was 13 years old at the time, and really I wasn't okay with it. It took me 16 years to go over it.
And now, 25 years after Roy Orbison's death, his sons have finally found a way to sing with their dad. For years, they'd been searching for a never-released song they'd heard about called The Way Is Love. Roy Jr. and Alex Orbison described for us how they found it.
Was it sitting in some shoebox in some attic somewhere? Where was it?
No. We have a place where we have all our archived items, and then outside of that, there's boxes of tapes and DACs and CDs and everything in the world. And everyone's looking, everyone's knee-deep in tapes. And then I was fatigued at this point, and so literally I went to lean on the wall. And I leaned, and when I looked back at my hand, there was a tape underneath my hand, and I literally, swear to God on my life, picked it up and went, oh.
So when you found this cassette and you put this on, what did it sound like? What was the quality of it?
It sounded so good, actually.
Yeah, it doesn't even matter what the quality is.
I listened to it and turned it up and thought, oh, this is the prettiest thing I've ever heard in my whole life. And then when we bounced it into the real stereo and turned it up.
Then you came back on hiss.
All it was hiss.
And then you realized, oh, we have issues.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. If I could be the one
to write the rules. Orbison had recorded the song using an old cassette deck and a Casio keyboard. 5 years ago, the quality would have been unusable. But with new software, German engineers were able to cleanly extract Orbison's vocals.
Now you want to hear where we took it?
Love to. Talk about the magic of technology,
yes,
the miracle
for sure.
Of technology.
Absolutely.
With the recovered track, the boys lived out a dream that had been delayed for 25 years. Wesley and Roy Jr. played guitar, Alex the drums, and they all sang background vocals. Orbison's lyrics, "Life is so much better when the way is love," suggest a farewell message, the secret of life passed on from a father to his boys.
I mean, it really is a man who at 50 was looking back on a whole life that was full of the highest highs and the lowest lows that a man could ever go through.
What's he getting at there?
That is the answer to all life's various problems. That's what we're left with on Earth. Ha ha.
really moving thing to think about.
Yes, it is.
Fittingly, The Way Is Love was produced by another artist who's the son of a music legend, John Carter Cash, Johnny and June Carter Cash's only child. The friendship between the Orbison and Cash families goes back several generations, which only imbued the entire experience with even more meaning for the boys.
Wow. Jim, thank you. What a great story.
Something else you want to add to the iPod.
Very
nice.
Absolutely.
It's beautiful.